destination reached. The Groundbreaker.
Here they come! Wow. You ever seen bones this cool?
And I say you're wrong.
Talk to my first mate if you have questions.
Llama?
I'm telling you, this isn't the rock. We need to turn back.
This is the spot. Now keep your eyes peeled. The dead drop is at the foot of the alpaca, he said. And this is the alpaca.
Llama.
What was that?
It's a llama we're after, sir. Not an alpaca. And this is neither.
Llama, alpaca, same thing.
Llama.
They aren't the same at all, sir. Believe it or not.
Enough. We've got company. Out with it then. Who are you?
You're a captain. Oh, thank the law. We're saved.
Excuse me, first mate. We aren't in danger, and last I checked, I'm still your captain. We're on the hunt for a package. It's supposed to be at the foot of this handsome-looking, alpaca-shaped rock.
Llama?
This handsome-looking, llama-shaped rock. But the goods aren't here. Must have been stolen.
Mister, I don't mean to tell you your business, but this here's a fossilized monster skeleton. Just about the coolest one I ever seen, too.
I'm not exactly an expert, but I think that's a fossil.
This is not a rock shaped like a llama. This is a fossil shaped like a fossil. Captain.
Could it be the fossil of a llama?
I highly doubt that. Can you believe this guy? Thank you.
Hey, I do the talking around here. This is the right spot. I know it in my gut. But there's no package, and now my crew is insubordinate. That won't be necessary. I have everything under control.
Could have fooled me.
First mate, this is a llama, and that's an order. Now find me that package. It's around here somewhere.
Hey, hear me out. You and I both know this isn't a llama. Not to mention his ego, his judgment, and his spine. If you backtrack and take the right-hand fork, I could have sworn I saw the rock there already. Captain wouldn't let us stop because the beak wasn't sharp enough to be a llama. Bingo. He won't even let us turn around because he's dug his heels into this fossil story. His pride is all tangled up in it. We're not getting off Gorgon without that package. If you can find the llama and the goods, you can have my cut of the take. I don't care. I just want out of here. I lost a lot of friends in that crash. All I got left are my idiot captain and a guy who can't stop saying llama. This isn't about money anymore. It's about survival and cutting my losses. Alpacas are cowards. Never trust an alpaca. They're small, they're mean, and they'll stab you in the back first chance they get. You're telling me. We'd be having a very different conversation if this were an alpaca-shaped rock.
Llama!
Don't let me down. That llama is my ticket out of here.
Llama. 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 Llama!
This ain't right. These folks never had a chance.
What happened to all these people?
Stalking. Thank you.
That's impressive.
I stumbled onto something big. Bigger than Minnie Ambrose's journal. Spacer's choice wasn't making adrenotype for humans. They were making it for canids. The ads were all smoke and mirrors. There's no way they'd make something this dangerous for people. But why? To build an army? Like in the Archie Excelsior comics? To make them smart so they can do most of our jobs? To make them smart and give them thumbs? So they can do all of our jobs? Only one way to find out.
What do you think of the Unreliable, Parvati?
There's always something to fix, and it's neat working in the Aether.
Ah!
Any luck tracking down that llama? Technically, it's the package I'm after, but you get what I mean. That's it! Oh, I can't wait to rub this in my dumb captain's face.
See here now? What's all this talk about?
We got the package. And guess what? It was where I said it would be. And this fossil? It's not a llama. Not a llama at all.
I believe I owe you an apology, First Mate.
What?
It's true. I wouldn't know an alpaca from a raptodon, and as a captain, that's a mark against my good name. Can you ever forgive me?
Llama.
I don't know what to say.
I'll start. Thank you, stranger. We weren't exactly at our best behavior today, were we, First Mate?
I suppose not, Captain. Spratjack, first round's on me.
Well, I am terribly thirsty.
Llama.
Here's my cut. I'd say you've earned it. And here's a little something extra for your time. Be seeing you, and thanks again.
Llama!
Thank you.
Sure would be a bad time for an earthquake.
Tell me about the production of Adrenotime, Dr. Ambrose. I hear Compound X is a unique challenge to work with.
It's temperamental. It must be refined under tightly controlled circumstances at tremendously low temperatures.
Do you compound it with anything else? Tell me more about your refining process. Our audience is conversant in the sciences, very detail-oriented, so don't be afraid to get technical.
Last time I met you, you spoke like a groundbreaker Bildersprat. Why the sudden airs and such specific questions? Does your minder know what you're up to? Does he suspect you're a spy?
Pardon me.
Thank you.
Oh, smells something awful. Poor fella had his outpost set up right near the trash.
Thank you.
I usually just kick him down.
I ain't think we're welcome here, Captain.
I almost just want to huck a rock in there and see what happens.
We call them marauders. Like they have some kind of group identity. They don't. The name was coined in Edgewater, I think. One of the towns first hit by the Adrenotime crisis. A lonely spacer's choice outpost on the edge of a barren sea. A prime place for the company to test a disastrous new product. When the town started fraying at the edges, hardly anyone else in the colony noticed.
Is this one of those research outposts we're looking for? Wow! Get a load of this view!
Death. When does a man become marauder? People talk about them as if they've transformed, like they've mutated. I see it in the Aetherwave broadcasts, read it in the papers. But beneath their masks, they're only people. Dangerous people, with a terrible illness, But people still. When we call a man a marauder, have we given up on him? How do we know when he's become one? How can you decide to give up on someone? Have I given up on Harvey? Who does this suffering serve, I wonder? Spacer's choice?